बिस्मिल्लाह रहमान रहीम स्टूडेंट्स, वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अ न्यू टॉपिक विच इज़ हीमोपोइसिस। हीमोपोइसिस इज़ द फर्स्ट चैप्टर ऑफ हीमाटोलॉजी, सो यू शुड लर्न सम बेसिक थिंग्स अबाउट हीमाटोलॉजी। सो फर्स्ट लेक्चर इज हीमोपोइसिस। What is hemoptysis? How hemoptysis can occur? Hemoptysis is actually the formation of new blood, blood cells are erythrocytes, thrombocytes or leukocytes. So formation of new blood cell is simply is known as hemoptysis. So as a hemoptysis starts from a single stem cell which is known as pluripotent stem cells. ठीक है, प्लूरिपोटेंट स्टेम सेल डिवाइड्स एंड फॉर्म न्यू लीनिएज एंड डिवाइड इनटू थ्री लीनिएज और थ्री कैटेगरीज और थ्री लीनिएज आर नोन एज एरिथ्रोसाइट लीनिएज विच इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ डब्ल्यू बी सीड्स एंड देन अ थ्रोम्बोसाइट लीनिएज विच इज फॉर द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ मेगा कैरियोसाइट्स एंड देन फॉर production of platelets. The third one is the responsible for the production of leukocytes, all types of leukocytes like agranulocytes and granulocytes. Stem cell, hemopoietic stem cell is 1 in 20 million. So formation of new blood cells occurs in the bone marrow. Stem cell is the pluripotent stem cell is present in the bone marrow, and it is 1 in every 20 million cells. So normally immunological testing, it is found that CD34 receptors are present on the surface of stem cells. So stem cells are positive for CD34 cells and negative for CD38 cells. Next we are going to discuss some important things. Now most important MCQs in UHS for allied health sciences is the site of hemoptysis in different ages. So in fetal life at initial point initial 2 months for occurs in yolk sac. So and then after two months till 7 months formation of blood cells sufficiently efficiently take place in liver cells, and after 5 to 9 months in fetal life occurs jo blood cells maturation, blood cell formation occurs in bone marrow. In infants mostly hemoptysis occurs in bone marrow, practically in all bones. So and in adult life in bone marrow hemoptysis occurs in the bone marrow of many bones like vertebrae, ribs, sternum and long bones and the end of long bones, etc. In fetal life, in initial fetal life, most of the hemoptysis observed in the AGM part of the fetus or in yolk sac. AGM actually a part of the mesoderm from where stem cell initially involves in the formation of blood. So what are unique about stem cells? Stem cells have the ability to self renewal after number of divisions, or usually after 50 divisions, or usually after limited or programmed divisions. Stem cells have the ability to renew itself. One stem cell is capable of producing about 10^6 mature blood cells after 20 cell division. Okay, you know as after limited way, every cell has a limited capacity to divide because telomeres usually become short in with every division. So same phenomena occurs in the stem cell. In case of stem cells, so that's why after 50 division cells, stem cell undergo for cell. Now in that now in this diagram you can observe cell lineage or cell production from the pluripotent stem cells. You can observe the after the division of stem cells, after the division of pluripotent stem cells, three cells are formed, and those three cells further undergo cell division and form new lineage or separate lineage. At extreme left side you can observe BFUE, basic jo hai basic unit involved in the formation of erythrocyte, so it's a erythrocyte lineage. So and CFUGEMM, common myeloid progenitor cell, is actually a basic cell which is responsible for the production of which is responsible for the start of lineage of erythrocytes or platelets or monocytes, neutrophils, eosinophil and basophil as well. So common myeloid cells then divides according to availability of growth factors or other factors. And many other factors acts on the CFUGEMM, granulocytes, erythrocytes, monocytes, megakaryocyte cells. So common myeloid cells, so cloniforming unit, which is a common myeloid progenitor cells, with the effect of many growth factors and other some factors, decides which lineage is necessary in needy condition. For example, in case of inflammation or in case of infection. So in case of infection, neutrophil need gets high. So lineage which is responsible for the production or line which is so production of neutrophil or lineage which is responsible for the production of neutrophils start producing neutrophils according to as infection is occurring, so neutrophils production becomes rapid. And in case of inflammation, monocyte production become increased, so lineage which is responsible for the production of neutrophils and monocyte becomes excited as compared to other. But in controlled condition, but in normal body condition, each cell division or new cell production, for leukocytes, erythrocytes, thrombocytes, megakaryocytes, production occurs according to normal concentration of cell in blood, in peripheral blood. So our initial cell is stem cell which divides and form common myeloid cell. The common myeloid cells then divide and form erythrocyte, basic unit for erythrocyte, cloniforming unit for megakaryocytes, and then similarly cloniforming unit for granulocytes, monocytes and eosinophil, and for eosinophil which then further divides and mature to form end product for basic unit for erythrocytes, end product for mature red blood cells, and the same from cloniforming unit and from cloniforming unit of megakaryocytes, the mature product will be platelets, and from cloniforming units of granulocytes, monocytes, end products will be monocytes and neutrophils or granulocytes. And same from cloniforming units of eosinophil, end product will be eosinophils. So सिमिलरली फॉर बेसोफिल्स एंड इन केस ऑफ लिम्फॉइड और कॉमन लिम्फॉइड प्रोजेनिटर सेल्स टी लिम्फोसाइट्स बी लिम्फोसाइट्स एंड नेचुरल किलर सेल्स प्रोड्यूस्ड नेचुरल किलर टी लिम्फोसाइट्स मेच्योर इन दिस सेकेंडरी लिम्फॉइड ऑर्गन फॉर एग्जाम्पल स्प्लीन थाइमस एंड लिम्फ नोड्स. स्टेम सेल नीड environment or home for survival or for production of new cells. So bone marrow is actually a environment or micro environment for the stem cell or for the production of new cell. In bone marrow there is another important environment is known as stroma of the bone marrow. A stroma is formed by the mesenchymal stem cells, adipose tissues, fibroblasts, osteoblasts, endothelial cells, and macrophages. These cells collectively form a micro environment which is responsible for the protection and which is responsible for the production of stem cells and the production of production and successfully production of new cells. So maintenance of environments or stroma of the bone marrow is necessary for the production of normal blood cell. In case of and now transcription factors, several transcription factors are also involved. Are also involved in the survival of stem cells. Those transcription factors which regulates the survival of stem cells. I am saying survival of stem cells are GATA1, GATA sorry GATA2, NOTCH1, and SCL factors. ठीक है. And other factors which are responsible for the which are for responsible for the differentiation are also involved in the differentiation. Some other factors are also involved in the regulation of differentiation from stem cell. So GATA2 and then GATA1 and FOG1 are play important role in the differentiation of in the regulation of differentiation of erythrocytes, megakaryocytes, and same is the case with the common myeloid lineage. PU1, the CEBP family acts on progenitor cells and helps in the regulation of differentiation from stem cell. In this chapter, tables are much important for you. Now our table 1.3, which is showing hematopoietic growth factors. Now another important topic is growth factors. Growth factors act on different growth factors acts on different styles, different cells or different or in different condition. Those which act on stromal cells are interleukin 1 and tumor necrosis factors. Similarly, those act on the pluripotent stem cells are SCF, FLT3, and vascular endothelial growth factors. Multipotential progenitor cells. And many growth factors like GCSF, granulocyte clone stimulating factor, monocyte clone stimulating factor, interleukin-5, erythropoietin and thrombopoietin acts on the committed progenitor cells. For example, which is responsible of those progenitor cells, which is responsible for the production of erythrocytes, erythropoietin acts on those progenitor cells. Similarly, those cells, those cloniforming units, which is responsible for the production of megakaryocytes, thrombopoietin acts on the those progenitor cells. So similarly, cells which are responsible for the production of granulocytes, GCSF acts on the cloni-stimulating factor or progenitor cells which are responsible for the production of granulocytes. Similarly, in case of monocytes, MCSF acts on the progenitor cells of monocytes. Here you can see some important characteristics of myeloid and lymphoid growth factors. Usually they are glycoprotein in nature and acts at very low concentration. And they are produced by many cells. Simple, usually affect more than one lineage. One growth factor usually acts more than one lineage or more than one progenitor. Cells usually show synergistic effect. It means one or more growth factor collectively, when one or more growth factor acts in combination, then their effect become more than its double effect. It means कि अगर कोई दो ग्रोथ फैक्टर आपस में इन कॉम्बिनेशन एक्ट करते हैं किसी चीज़ पर, तो उनका इफेक्ट उनके डबल इफेक्ट से ज़्यादा हो जाता है. इसको कहा जाता है सिनर्जिस्टिक इफेक्ट. देन एडिक्टिव इंटरेक्शन विद अदर ग्रोथ फैक्टर्स ऑफन एक्ट ऑन न्यूक्लियोप्लास्टिक इक्विवेलेंट ऑफ नॉर्मल सेल्स. देन आ जाता है मल्टीपल एक्शन. फॉर एग्जाम्पल ग्रोथ फैक्टर्स हैव मल्टीपल एक्शन लाइक दे आर रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर द प्रोलीफ्रेशन, डिफ्रेंशिएशन, मैचुरेशन, फंक्शनल एक्टिवेशन, प्रिवेंशन ऑफ अपोप्टोसिस ऑफ प्रोजेनिटर सेल्स. सो मैनी ग्रोथ फैक्टर्स एक्ट ऑन प्रोजेनिटर सेल्स एंड ग्रोथ फैक्टर्स आर एक्चुअली रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर द इनिशिएशन और फॉर द प्रोलीफ्रेशन और फॉर द डिफ्रेंशिएशन और फॉर द मैचुरेशन एंड मैनी अदर फंक्शन ऑफ प्रोजेनिटर सेल. विदाउट ग्रोथ फैक्टर्स देर आर चांसेज ऑफ एबनॉर्मल प्रोडक्शन और एबनॉर्मल प्रोडक्शन ऑफ ब्लड सेल. सो लैक ऑफ ग्रोथ फैक्टर्स और एबनॉर्मल प्रोडक्शन ऑफ ग्रोथ फैक्टर्स और जेनेटिकली डेफिशिएंसी ऑफ एनी ग्रोथ फैक्टर्स कैन डैमेज द ग्रोथ ऑफ नॉर्मल ग्रोथ ऑफ ब्लड सेल्स. यू हैव ऑब्जर्व्ड सम टारगेट्स फॉर द ग्रोथ फैक्टर्स इन फ्यू स्लाइड्स अगो, जिसके अंदर एक टेबल दिखाया हुआ था कि ग्रोथ फैक्टर किस किस पर किस सेल पर एक्ट करेगा. नाउ ग्रोथ फैक्टर फॉर द कंप्लीट एक्शन ऑफ द और बाइंडिंग ऑफ द ग्रोथ फैक्टर ऑन टारगेट सेल्स मस्ट हैव रिसेप्टर्स फॉर स्पेसिफिक ग्रोथ फैक्टर्स. सो बायोलॉजिकल इफेक्ट ऑफ ग्रोथ फैक्टर्स आर मीडिएटेड थ्रू स्पेसिफिक रिसेप्टर्स ऑन टारगेटेड सेल्स. और हम जो कि पिछली स्लाइड में एक टेबल देख चुके हैं, ठीक है. मैनी रिसेप्टर्स लाइक एरिथ्रोपोएटिन, एपोरिसेप्टर और जीएमसीएसएफ रिसेप्टर्स, ग्रैनुलोसाइट्स, मोनोसाइट्स, क्लोनिंग स्टिमुलेटिंग फैक्टर्स आर प्रेजेंट ऑन द रिस्पेक्टिव प्रोजेनिटर सेल्स. दोज प्रोजेनिटर सेल्स विच आर रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर द प्रोडक्शन ऑफ एरिथ्रोसाइट्स. सो एपोरिसेप्टर्स आर प्रेजेंट ऑन दोज प्रोजेनिटर सेल्स. दोज विच आर रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर द प्रोडक्शन ऑफ ग्रैनुलोसाइट्स, मोनोसाइट्स आर प्रेजेंट. दोज रिसेप्टर्स विच आर रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर द production of granulocytes, monocytes are present on the surface of GM-CSF. So when growth factors attached on the outer domain of the receptors, binds with the receptors site which present at the outside of the cells, then dimerization of receptors occur. So after dimerization, or in simple wording, after activation in the receptors, internal domain of receptors gets active. Internal domain which is present in the cytoplasm of the cell. So internal domain gets activated, JAK or STAT pathway gets activated, mitogen activated protein kinase pathway initiates, and phosphatidyl linositol 3 kinase pathway helps in the signal transduction. So receptors and signal transduction pathways are important for you in UHS point of view, because few MCQs had seen in from growth factors table, and much important table is the site where blood cells form, which was the first table of the lecture. So, with respect to UHS, you have to know something like these pathways. The name of pathways you must know or must know for UHS exam. Now, in this diagram, you can observe. You can observe easily some pathways which are signal transducing pathways through which complete activation occur, complete activation or whatever the responsibility of cell happen in growth factor binds with the receptors at outside of the cell. So JAK pathway, Janus kinase 3 pathway, gets activated so kinase enzyme gets activated, and after dimerization of this receptor and the RAS pathway, RAS gets activated. You know the RAS gene or RAS protein, you had studied in nucleasia, in chapter of nucleasia about RAS protein or RAS gene. So JAK activates the RAS protein, RAS activates the RAF, or RAF activate enters into the nucleus where they activate MAP kinase pathway. MAP kinase involves in the gene expression, gene expression. So as RAS is the proliferative gene, so they are involved in the proliferation of cells. So elongation factor 2 rhabdo gene and the p53 gene also gets activated, and the cell cycle gets start. It means the cell proliferation. Similarly, from another side, another family of signaling family like STATs gets activated, which also involves in the activation of gene expression. So after gene expression, cell cycle or protein formation gets start. So when protein formation or gene expression happens, then cell cycle gets start. Cell cycle moves from G node phase to S phase, as synthesis phase to then after few minutes, after a few times, cell divides, cell multiplies and divide, and single cell become double. But here is another important thing: apoptosis during the multiplication of the cell. Apoptosis gets blocked by the API3 kinase pathway. So you must know well about the signal transducing pathways of the cell proliferation. These pathways happens in the प्रोजेनिटर सेल्स. प्रोजेनिटर सेल डिसाइड्स के किस लीनिएज में भेजना है, आरबीसी बनना है, एरिथ्रोसाइट सॉरी थ्रोम्बोसाइट बनेगा या फिर लिम्फोसाइट बनेगा. सो इट डिपेंड्स अपॉन द कंडीशंस, इट्स डिपेंड अपॉन द नीड्स, इट्स डिपेंड ऑन मैनी फैक्टर्स. Now another topic is erythropoiesis. Erythropoiesis is the formation of red blood cells. You know, in our body, if RBCs have the limited lifespan, usually around 120 days. So I'm discuss the counting or normal quantity of RBCs in few next slides. In this table, you can briefly or you can observe some important values, diameters of cells, like RBCs have usually a diameter range from 6 to 8 micrometer, and the lifespan of RBC is 120 days. Normal count in male is usually 4.5 to 6.5 into 10 is 12 per liter. So normal function of RBCs, you know the normal function of RBCs, hemoglobin is present inside the RBCs, oxygen, hemoglobin is oxygen carrying protein, so oxygen binds with the protein or hemoglobin, and RBCs moves into in blood and as oxygen carrier. So oxygen and carbon dioxide transport through RBCs. Platelets are usually 0.5 to 3.0 micrometer in diameter, and usually average time of one platelet is 10 days in the blood. So number of usually it's 140 to 400 400 into 10 is 9 per liters. They are involved in the hemostasis or maintenance of environment of blood with respect to clotting. So platelets are normally involved in the clot formation, but in normal circumstances or inactivated form or unactivated form, platelets are not undergo the formation of clot. Neutrophils are usually 12 to 15 micrometer in diameter, so neutrophils are larger in size as compared to RBCs. So one neutrophil lifespan is average lifespan is 6 to 10 hours only, and their counting is 1.8 to 7.5 into 10 to the 9 per liter. Usually neutrophils are important role in the infection. Neutrophils are phagocytic cells, so they kill the phagocyte host and kill the bacteria or other infectious agents. So monocytes are usually 20 to 40 hours have 20 to 40 hours lifespan. They usually involve in the inflammation, they are also involved in the protection protection from other infections and bacteria by causing inflammation. So monocytes are usually present in the form of macrophages inside the tissue. In peripheral blood, they are present in the form of monocytes. Eosinophils are responsible in response to allergic reaction. So in allergic reaction or in parasitic infections, eosinophil count gets increase. So usually in normal circumstances, 0.04 to 0.44 into 10 is 9 per liter eosinophils present in the blood. Their increased count in blood shows allergic or parasitic infection in most of the cases. Basophils are very rare cells in the blood, so 0.01 to 0.1 into 10 is power. A normal lifespan of a single basophil is few days. Similarly with the case of eosinophil. So basophils are also a granular nature, so they works with somehow like with the inflammation with the monocytes or with the other cells. They are responsible for the they are somehow responsible in the inflammation. Lymphocytes, there are two types of lymphocytes, B lymphocytes and T lymphocytes. Lymphocytes are involved in the immune system of the body. So B and T cells are the most important cells for the immune system of our body. WBCs, so बी सेल्स फॉर्म्स द बी सेल्स आर इन्वॉल्व इन द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ एंटीबॉडीज अगेंस्ट एनी एंटीजन विच इज एंटरिंग इन टू बॉडी आफ्टर फ्यू डेज आफ्टर फ्यू टाइम्स देन टी सेल्स आर गिव्स प्रोटेक्शन अगेंस्ट यूजली वायरसेज मोस्ट ऑफ टी सेल्स आर नॉट इन्वॉल्व इन डायरेक्टली नॉट टी सेल्स आर नॉट डायरेक्टली इन्वॉल्व इन द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ एंटीबॉडीज दे protects our body against usually against viruses so lymph so increased T cell count in blood shows the usually shows the viral infection सो नॉर्मल जो लाइफ स्पैन है बी और टी सेल्स का जो है वो यूजली फ्यू वीक्स टू और ईयर्स तक भी हो सकता है सी यू कैन ऑब्जर्व ऑटोमेटेड एनालाइजर और सेल काउंटर ऑफ द ब्लड इन आवर ब्लड एज यू नो बेसिकली थ्री टाइप्स ऑफ सेल्स आर प्रेजेंट आर बी सी डब्ल्यू बी सी एंड प्लेटलेट्स सो डब्ल्यू बी सी काउंटिंग इज डब्ल्यू बी सी इज काउंटिंग इन ऑटोमेटेड एनालाइजर और सेल काउंटर्स occur through flow cytometry. So for the flow cytometry, only WBCs only WBCs are required. So before reaching into the WBC or flow cytometry chamber, on flow cytometry chamber, lysis of RBCs occur. So lytic agent lyses the RBCs and only WBCs enters in the flow cytometry chamber where different types of WBCs are counting. For example, counting of neutrophils, eosinophils, basophils, monocytes, lymphocytes, जो है वो हो जाती है. So we can get five. There are two types of cell counters: five differential or three part differential or five part differential cell counters. Five part differential cell counter calculate five different types of WBCs, but only three part differential cell counter can calculate only neutrophils, lymphocytes, or mixed category. So now RBCs and platelet counter is separate. RBC and platelet counter or RBC and platelet counter part is separate with WBCs in single automated cell counter. A simple EDTA mixed blood without clotting ब्लड जो है उसको यूज़ किया जाता है. EDTA जो है वो क्या है. EDTA इज़ एन एंटी कोगुलेंट. सो एंटी कोगुलेंट मिक्स्ड ब्लड जो है वो ऐड किया जाता है. सो सैंपल जो है वो प्रोब के ज़रिए एक ऑटोमेटेड एनालाइजर एक सैंपल को प्रोब के ज़रिए क्या करता है सक करता है. आफ्टर सकिंग ऑफ अप्रोप्रिएट अमाउंट ऑफ सैंपल और कैलकुलेटेड अमाउंट ऑफ सैंपल्स सैंपल अंडरगो थ्री डिफरेंट कैटेगरीज और थ्री डिफरेंट स्टेप्स. फर्स्ट एंड सेकेंड स्टेप इज द काउंटिंग ऑफ प्लेटलेट एंड RBCs रिस्पेक्टिवली. सो देर इज़ नो लाइसिस ऑफ RBCs इन फर्स्ट एंड सेकेंड स्टेप. In for the counting of platelets there is no need to be to of the lysis of RBCs. So but in the last but in the counting of WBCs lysis of red blood cells is required. So after lysis or after complete procedure within a few seconds or within few minutes we can observe and we can observe different values or different concentration of RBC or of cells in our blood on monitor screen or computer screen. So stimulation of RBC's production is the responsibility of erythropoietin. Erythropoietin is protein which released from the usually maximum 90% of erythropoietin released from the kidney. So kidney which is responsible for the production of erythropoietin. Erythropoietin moves into the bone marrow where progenitor cells of erythrocytes are present. So early BFU, early unit for early basic unit for the erythrocytes, and the late basic unit for the erythrocyte productions are progenitor cells which originate from pluripotent stem cells, as we have discussed in few slides, previous slides. A new a pronormoblast is formed. What is pronormoblast form? An initial immature cell from colony forming unit of erythrocyte is normoblast, which is not mature. Normoblast have a large nucleus or large dense nucleus. Then another stage is after normal blast is reticulocyte. Normal blast nucleus is present, so normal blasts are nucleated cells. So reticulocytes, nucleus, dense nucleus is not present. Only small incluents are present in the cells, which are the which are actually a part of nucleus. So in normoblast, when reticulocyte production occurring, then nucleus undergo destruction. So in the destruction or in the resorption of the nucleus, few granules or few incluents remains in the blood, remains in the WBC. So this stage is known as reticulocyte. So reticulocyte count helps in the diagnosis of many diseases in adults or in children. Reticulocyte then become mature and RBCs enter into the bloodstream. Mature RBCs moves into the blood and performs their function of oxygen and carbon dioxide transportation. कितनी है हमारी बॉडी को आरबीसीज की, ये डिपेंड करता है इसकी वजह से. आपने देखा होगा एरिथ्रोपोएटिन स्टिमुलेशन होती है. इट मीन इफ वी नीड अ लार्ज अमाउंट रैपिड और लार्ज अमाउंट ऑफ आरबीसीज इन केस ऑफ एनी इंजरी आरबीसीज. सो ब्लड लॉस की वजह से क्या हुआ, आरबीसीज की अमाउंट कम हो गई है. सो when anybody suffers from the deficiency of RBCs, then erythropoietin production then gets increased, and more reticulocytes can be found in blood in case of blood loss, because there is a rapid production or rapid maturation of RBCs occurring. So we can find more reticulocytes in blood as compared to in normal circumstances. जो सेल्स थे जिनमें न्यूक्लियस था, जैसे हमने कहा नॉर्मोब्लास्ट और प्रो नॉर्मोब्लास्ट, सीरियस आफ्टर जब नॉर्मोब्लास्ट बन जाता है तो नॉर्मल ब्लास्ट के कुछ कैरेक्टर, दे ऑल्सो कंटेन प्रोग्रेसिवली मोर हीमोग्लोबिन विच स्टेन पिंक इन द साइटोप्लाज्म, और साइटोप्लाज्म स्टेन्स पेलर ब्लू. As it loses RNA and protein synthetic apparatus, while nucleic chromatin becomes more dense. जैसे मैंने आपको बताया कि न्यूक्लियस क्या होता है, ज़्यादा डेंस होता है नॉर्मल ब्लास्ट के अंदर, और ज़्यादा डार्कली स्टेन्ड भी होता है, ठीक है. न्यूक्लिएटेड रेड ब्लड सेल्स नॉर्मल ब्लास्ट सेल्स नॉट प्रेजेंट इन द नॉर्मल ह्यूमन पेरिफेरल ब्लड. A few or limited amount of few percentage of reticulocytes are present in peripheral blood, but normoblasts usually in normal adult person normoblasts should not be present in peripheral blood. They appear in the blood if erythropoiesis occurring outside the marrow, जिसको कहा जाता है extramedullary erythropoiesis, also with some marrow diseases. एंड इन लास्ट स्टेज जब आरबीसी मेच्योर हो जाता है, कम्प्लीटली पिंक स्टेनिंग मेच्योर एरिथ्रोसाइट्स रिजल्ट्स विच इज़ अ नॉन न्यूक्लिएटेड बायो बाई कनकेव डिस्क। सो दो करेक्टरिस्टिक्स याद रखें, पहली बात बाई कनकेव डिस्क की तरह का होता है एंड एंड विदाउट न्यूक्लियस होता है। सो ए न्यूक्लिएटेड नॉन न्यूक्लिएटेड ए न्यूक्लिएटेड एंड बाई कनकेव डिस्क इज अ शेप ऑफ मेच्योर आरपीसी और फाइनल एरिथ्रोसाइट। यू कैन कंपेयर थ्री डिफरेंट स्टेजेस ऑफ थ्री डिफरेंट स्टेजेस ऑफ आरबीसी फॉर्मेशन। नॉर्मल ब्लास्ट इज यूजली ग्रेटर देन रेटिकुलोसाइट्स एंड मेच्योर आर ब्लड सेल्स विच इज नॉर्मल ब्लास्ट इज प्रेजेंट ओनली इन बोन मैरो। सो न्यूक्लियस एंड न्यूक्लियस इज प्रेजेंट इन ओनली इन नॉर्मोब्लास्ट। इन रेटिकुलोसाइट्स फ्यू इंक्लूजन्स कैन बी सीन बट अ टिपिकल न्यूक्लियस इज एबसेंट इज ऑल्सो इन रेटिकुलोसाइट। इन मेच्योर आर बी सीज नो एनी इंक्लूजन और न्यूक्लियस इज प्रेजेंट। आर एन ए प्रेजेंट इन द नॉर्मल ब्लास्ट विच इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर द प्रोडक्शन ऑफ मैनी प्रोटीन्स। रेडिकुल इन आर एन ए इज ऑल्सो प्रेजेंट इन रेडिकुलोसाइट्स एंड इन मेच्योर आर बी सीज यूजली आर एन ए इज ऑल्सो एबसेंट। इन मैरो नॉर्मल ब्लास्ट यूजली एग्जिस्ट इन मैरोज और इन पेरिफेरल टिश्यू और इन पेरिफेरल ब्लड। इन नॉर्मल सर्कमस्टांसिस यूजली रेटिकुलोसाइट्स सॉरी यूजली नॉर्मल ब्लास्ट आर एबसेंट इन पेरिफेरल ब्लड्स। मेच्योर आर बी सीज एंड रेटिकुलोसाइट्स काउंट्स रेटिकुलोसाइट्स ऑल्सो प्रेजेंट इन द बोन मैरो बिकॉज मेच्योरेशन इज हैपनिंग इन द बोन मैरो। सो आर बी सीज ऑल्सो प्रेजेंट इन द बोन मैरो ऑफ बोन मैरो। सो इन ब्लड इन पेरिफेरल ब्लड नॉर्मल ब्लास्ट आर एबसेंट। ओनली रेटिकुलोसाइट्स ओनली लिमिटेड परसेंटेज ऑफ रेटिकुलोसाइट्स काउंट एंड द नॉर्मल रेंज ऑफ रेड ब्लड और मेच्योर रेड ब्लड सेल्स इज प्रेजेंट इन पेरिफेरल ब्लड।